The move to have zero value-added tax on various construction supplies come August 2nd, according to Housing Minister Richard Frederick, is one that is pregnant with economic viability. This comes amid economic woes impacting the average St. Lucian and the implementation of a 2.5% levy on items already attracting VAT.
Removal of VAT on construction material, being plywood, steel, lumber, and the likes. This is meant to stimulate economic activity. It is meant to give persons an opportunity to at least own their homes or to refurbish their homes. I saw, unfortunately, a letter written by the leader of the opposition in which he accuses the Prime Minister of not knowing the importance of the construction industry. And I mean, that falls flat on naivety, because if the very Prime Minister is not aware of how important the construction industry is to economic development, why on earth would the Prime Minister see it necessary to remove VAT on the materials that basically spearhead a construction activity?
Frederick says the government in doing so has acted in the best interest of the people, with cries of economic hardships echoing throughout the island. The minister says the move will allow for several benefits, which include home ownership and the creation of employment.
Here we are choosing the best option, what is best for the electorate of this country, i.e. a reduction in prices and persons on basically an altar of political posturing will see that persons do eat plywood bread. But at the end of the day, if the argument is correct, or if the argument carries a dint of credibility, we now ask, who are the persons building the houses for those rich people? Wouldn't those rich people need laborers? Wouldn't they need plumbers? Wouldn't they need electricians? Wouldn't they need masons and carpenters? So the argument, no matter how you look at it from a standpoint of what the opposition seem to be spewing, is nonsensical. All how you turn it.
The housing minister remains optimistic of the prospects following this move, while the government continues to work in the best interest of the St. Lucian people. For the TBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.